Hey everybody, it's ZeGreatGallade and welcome back to more Super Smash Bros. Brawl, the Subspace Emissary. In the last episode, we went through the lake, there was a solid three sections of it, and fought off with Rayquaza in our attempt to find out where Donkey Kong is, and doing so, we got Fox on our team, but in this episode, we're going to head straight into the Ruined Zoo. And, yet again, another plot point will be introduced. Let's go! Uh-oh. Looks like poor little Luke is getting chased by... Oh god, I feel really bad. I forget this thing's name. This isn't... I don't know what it is. Because, like, I think I have some kind of idea, but I don't want to say it just in case, like, I don't know. I say something I shouldn't in terms of, like, spoiler-wise. Even though, I don't know, this game's old, so it doesn't really matter. But Lucas is a newcomer to Super Smash Bros. One of the most beloved characters from the Smash Bros. Series, and he originally wasn't in Super Smash Bros. 4, and technically he isn't, but he was brought as a DLC character, so that's always good. So right off the bat, you can see that Lucas is a lot like Ness, and he is. Lucas is a lot like like Ness, and except for, I mean, his side special, which is... I mean, his specials are generally the same. He's got the PK Thunder and Fire, but Lucas's PK Fire goes in a straight line, whereas Ness's has a bit of a curve or diagonal slant on it, even in the air, and it more kind of brushes the foe. If you see here, if I could do it on the thing here. Uh-oh. This thing's gonna fall in the water. It's just gonna absolutely destroy me. Whereas Ness's would, like, stay on the ground and continue to do damage. And another one of these just spawn out of the sky randomly. Oh dear. So speaking of Lucas' similarities to Ness, here we have the man himself, Ness. So we are about to enter into a boss fight. Ness has been Ness has been in the Smash Bros. Series since the start. So obviously we're not going to go over him, but we still have stuff to go over with Lucas. So let's head straight into it, starting with Lucas. And inside the statue was good old Porky. Good old Porky, I love him. Not really. So I said about Lucas's PK Fire, but unlike Ness, Lucas's PK Thunder is actually quite different. Instead of Ness's would normally just hit the enemy or other character and just stop, whereas Lucas's actually goes through it like penetrates through and you can just keep spamming it like that. Whereas you wouldn't be able to do that with Ness. Also, if you hit yourself, it's the same logic if you had to hit yourself with this, opposed to just standing, just being hit with it and you staying put, if this makes sense. Hopefully it does. Uh-oh. Let's hope this smart bomb doesn't go off when I'm right near it. Can I have a PK for... There we go. Perfect. And, well, since Ness has his PK flash, which is an extremely awesome move, but it's quite hard to get off. Lurikus also has his variation of that, and it's PK Freeze. And, well, as you can imagine, PK Freeze freezes the opponent. Oh, in this case, in the Subspace Emissary, you don't really freeze bosses. That'd be pretty cool if you could. But it does freeze enemies and characters if you're just casually brawling. And, I don't know, I don't really use PK Freeze when I'm just playing Lucas normally. I mean, I don't really play Lucas to begin with. I'm gonna get killed from this. But anyway, he does have two spikes, actually. He's got his down aerial and his back aerial, which is a spike. So anyway, let's just finish Porky off and grab the Super Mushroom. Oh dear, another act of chivalry. Ness has sacrificed himself to save Lucas, and Lucas lacks the courage to fight against Wario. And so he meets up with yet a new character that has introduced to Super Smash Bros. Brawl, the Pokemon Trainer. So, there are a couple of things that are quite unique about the Pokemon Trainer that I won't actually go over because, there's really, I don't know, it plays into the Subspace Emissary, and I really love how this works, because, well, okay, I might go over it slightly, but the Pokemon Trainer is supposed to have three Pokemon, and you switch between them using your down special, whereas if I try and use my down special, we don't have said Pokemon. If you look at the Pokemon Trainer right there, he can't do anything for whatever reason. It looks really odd. But yeah, that's because in the Subspace Emissary, you actually, as part of the story, go and collect the Pokemon for the Pokemon Trainer. And this, well, I thought this was, like, amazing when I first played this game because, I don't know, it's really cool. You wouldn't really expect something like this to happen. But I guess since, like, you can do this type of stuff with the Pokemon Trainer, and I love it so much. But anyway, let's get into Squirtle. The Pokemon Trainer doesn't do anything himself, but he does have access to Squirtle. And Squirtle, he's very light. I like playing as Squirtle. I would probably play as Squirtle the most. I'm not going to pick up that hammer. But his attacks, I don't know, he's a very light character. And I've said before, I like playing with light characters. His neutral special, if I cannot get hit by this flu, consists of charging up a water gun, but the funny thing is, if you use it like this, it's similar to Mario's flood. So, unfortunately, it doesn't actually do any damage, but if you just do this, you don't charge it up at all. It actually does like a couple percent. I like to call it bubble, even though it's not really called bubble, it's still called water gun. His up special is waterfall, I believe it is. It's waterfall or surf, one of the two. I'd assume waterfall because you're going up. And his side special is similar to that of Yoshi's side special, because Yoshi's been throughout the game in previous Smash Bros. Games. Can I get a flow? No, I can't. I'm bad at doing that. This flow is gonna kill me. Please don't kill me. Oh no, it's gonna kill me. Ah! Oh, I just got saved. No, I didn't. Oh, there's a thing above me. Alright, sweet. That means I can't get killed. I'll only get killed off the side. Oh, can I hit these things? Wow, that was a really bad display of... ah, this platform! There we go. Get me some food. But I believe it's called... I believe it's Withdraw is the name, if I had to relate it to the Pokemon move. And you do get a bit of super armor when you're doing it, so that's cool. And here we are locked in a fight with some Primates. Just gotta watch out for them. I'll use a bit of waterfall here. There we go. Get rid of that Boom Primid. And a back air, that's actually pretty strong. His back and up airs are actually quite strong. It did... made really quick work of those flows. Flues. I'm gonna call them flows from now on. I don't really care. Oh no. Ouch. Punch me in straight into the spikes. Can I get a heart container after this, please? No? Alright. Okay. Now, when I first played this game, I didn't know what to do here because this right here is actually a door. Who would have thought? Anyway, we're inside now, hit this switch, and now we're in the water. I think Squirtle can actually drown. Yes, it can. That's really weird. Squirtle should not be able to drown. I mean, it's a water type, for crying out loud. Although, do turtles drown? Nah, they don't. What am I talking about? I'm thinking of tortoise. Alright, let's just get rid of all these bite-ins. The gimmick between this enemy is that it'll clone itself and can make these locked battles very irritating. Except this guy keeps cloning himself into the water. It's quite easy to make work of him. Anyway, up here, if you go on this up path here... Oh no, Glunder, please, please, please. You'll be able to get a golden box containing a trophy in my case. And there is a spawner from these Glunders. Oh, good tech myself. Oh no. They're also spawning Bitons, I believe. Alright, can we... There we go. Is there anything down here? I might want to check that just in case. There's a... always forget your name. There's also a Jike. Alright, let's just not deal with that. Let's not deal with these Bitons. Just run away. And we're at the door. And into another stage. This... oh, this song. I love this so much. It's just a remix of the Galactic Battle. And it is beautiful. One of my favorite themes in this game. I want you guys to listen to it for a sec. That was interesting in terms of those mushrooms. But yeah, quite a cool theme if I do say so myself. Anyway, if we come down here, we can see that there's a secret door back here. And in the secret door, like every other secret door, contains a golden box with a CD. And a... ooh, I could have used that before Squirtle died. Anyway, these platforms will crumble, so be careful of that. You don't want to get hit by the ice spikes. But yeah, those two maximum tomatoes would have come in very... useful hands if my Squirtle did not die. Oh well, he's still sitting on the sidebar there with those lives. What's in here? More food that I could have used for Squirtle. Yay. Man, Lucas has some amazing up smashes. Well, he only has one up smash, but you get what I mean. He's even got the like the headbutt from a Ness. Alright, get that home run bat, use the spring to get up here. In a locked battle, it's just... oh, that was quite a good use of the Pokemon Bat. Oop, up smash. And get rid of you. Get rid of you. Uh oh, I'm getting flamethrowered here. Ouch. Now you boom. Boom pirates. Wait, what is? Boomerang go. What? Oh, you've got a hammer here. Let's use that. Oh no. Oh no! Just my luck. Oh dear. Alright, let's get some stickers and. Dang it! Oh god. With these rays of light, let's just get out of here. And with that, we have cleared the stage of the Ruined Zoo. So, trophy-wise, we only got one trophy. Freezy. Anyway, we got Telly from Chibi Robo, the Flower Fairy Lip from Nintendo Puzzle Collection, I think I've gotten that before, Wild Gunman, and Bowser from Mario Kart 64, as well as a song this time, Mike's song from JP. What that stands for, I have no idea, actually. If I remember to edit that in, I will. Anyway, with that, we have Lucas and the Pokemon trainer that has joined our team. Alright, so if I check a couple things, I believe we are good to go into the Battlefield Fortress. Seems as though the subspace is consuming, or at least those rob monsters, or robots, monsters, those robots are releasing those subspace bombs. But anyway, here we are, Marth, the Prince of Fire Emblem. Oh, he's the Prince of something, and I don't know if it's Fire Emblem, it's gotta be something else. Well, I do know he's from Fire Emblem, he's just the Prince of something, and I forget it. Makes me feel really bad. Ooh, two trophy stands. I like it. We got a beam pyramid, and we'll get another beam pyramid. Because why not? You can never have enough trophies. Anyway, Marth, as many of you might know, has been here from the beginning. So, of course, we won't be going over him. But, can I just say, I love Marth. I'm trying to, like, main him in Super Smash Bros. 4, and, like, in doing that, it translates over to Super Smash Bros. Brawl slightly. But, man, Marth's, like, I don't know. He's really cool. I love his aerials. His aerials are honestly, like, one of my favorites. His back air and forward air are just so good to just rack up combos. And he's got some pretty good grabs, too. Like, at a high enough percentage, his up throw is a kill throw, so. Anyway, here we are going to take this key and throw it into this right here. And there's a door here, which I might not want to go in, because I'm going to see if there's anything else for us to discover over here. Let's see. We got a fire gyke. It's an interesting new variation on the gyks. Let's just crouch. There we go. Ah, damn it, I was trying to... Can I... Oh my goodness. Thank you. That took a while. Here we got an extra life. And back here is where we just entered, I believe. Oh no, there's another door here. I think that locked door was actually a secret door. So let's go. Oh, damn it. Ouch. Tech, please. Alright, there we go. Let's just keep going over and go back to that locked door. Are these going to spawn again? No, they're not. Sweet. Let's see. We've got a chain chomp in here, and we're going to have some health. A heart container. Sweet. So yeah, we might want to make note of this. It's pretty simple though, because like when you're going down these steps, you do find this key, so obviously you want to check what's there. But yeah, that's definitely going to contribute, and hopefully we can get this first try, because I'm not sure if there's anything sneaky. I mean, a couple of these levels, there are a couple of sneaky secrets that, well, I'm not too, I don't remember all too well. But it always is good to just look around, and I'm just going to head straight into this door. So chilling with 5 lives, oh no, how are we going to get through? We can't hit it. Well, if we do master down tilt, we can easily hit that. And here we're introduced to, what are you? You are the Eroda. These guys are cool, I like him. If we hit this switch, I believe, it will trigger a bunch of enemies to fall down. Yay. But that's fine. It's just more things for us to destroy, more items for us to collect, more bombs for us to trigger. Alright, the fan, the beautiful fan. I love it. Wait, what? What was that? Like, hit me twice. Oh well. Let's get rid of the spark. And the rotor. Ooh, Franklin badge. Oh, thank you very much. Alright, let's just run. I don't want to have to deal with this rotor. Just keep running through. Enter the door. Oh dear, here we go. We are going to be thrusted straight into a little wave fight. But we're introduced to a new character, Meta Knight. The Uber of Super Smash Bros. Anyway, Meta Knight is basically Kirby with a sword, really. Except you don't get to suck up enemies. I mean, I'm just saying that because he's got 5 jumps. But Meta Knight is a very broken character. I mean, I don't exactly know how to use him to his fullest potential, but he was banned in Smash Bros. Tournaments because he was too good, and he makes his own rank, the S rank. So it's kind of like Mega Rayquaza almost. But yeah, here we are, just dealing with a bunch of Primids in a wave fight, waves of Primids. Let's just take the spicy curry and just run through. We have a bit of wind here, actually. If I stand still, we're actually getting pushed along. Oh, I hate these guys. These buckets. They're so annoying. They just keep, like, dropping stuff on you. You never know what it is. But anyway, Meta Knight has his neutral special as a tornado, which it's, I don't know, I'm not too sure how I feel about the move. That's his side special, which you can actually direct slightly. If you spam the button for his neutral special, if I can pull it off, you actually do rise into the air a little bit, but if you stay, it actually does last a little longer, whereas if you just press it once, he'll stay on the ground, and he won't. Oh, really? That's not mine? That's, oh man, Greep, get out of here. Oh, I totally got hit by that spike. Oh dear. Uh-oh. Please let me show off all of Meta Knight before I die. Yeah, so if you do hold it down... oh no, my shield broke. Okay, good. We're good. So yeah, if you do hold it down once, it'll be a much shorter, but you will stay on the ground. Meta Knight's up special, however, allows him to go into the air. He does like a kind of flip of sorts. Oh man, that's unfortunate. Alright, let's suicide. I gotta show off Meta Knight. Sorry, Marth. His down special is actually one where... Oh, it happened again. He will do like a kind of disappearing act. I don't know what it is. Oh, I have the bunny hood, jeez. But if you hold down the down special button, he will actually do a sword slice, which does quite a bit of damage, actually. But yeah, his up special, you can glide and direct it. Like Pit, if you hold down the jump button after you do one fly, Meta Knight will go into a flight mode, and you can kind of direct it, not really. I mean, if you hit up, because it uses a bit of gravity, so obviously you won't be able to. Yeah, so you can do a bit of cool tricks with that. Not really. This is a fighting game, not a just chill. But anyway, we're gonna finish things off just like that. And get thrusted straight into a new level. So, here we are with more primids. There's a shooter, a scope primid. I was gonna say shooter primid. Thinking of the shooter me. Oh no, the gunner me is his name. Huh, so I got it wrong anyway. He's off the screen! No, he'll blow himself up. Just wait. Oh, okay. Or he'll just run to my area. Just tech that. Do a couple smash attacks. And now let's not kill ourselves using this hammer. Will we even get to use it? Yes, we will. The auto lance. I'm so sorry. I just absolutely destroyed you. Alright, let's get that life back since I suicide with Marth. Let's eat these maximum tomatoes. And let's just go for a fly. Never mind, the stage is going to be auto-scrolling, so I won't even be able to fly. Do some dash dancing while we're at it. Okay. Let's get rid of this auto-lance. Oh, there's a Totodile trophy right here. Please let me get this. Thank you. Let's not die. Let's just glide a little bit. Pop-Ant, give me some food. I'm feeling a little hungry here. Alright. Oops, you jumped over my smash attack. You won't do it this time. And we got another hammer. You're gone, you're gone, you're gone, and... Jeez, this creep has a lot of health. I can't even see you. Oh, well. Alright. Let's just do the tornado thing. Or not. This thing is gonna destroy me. Alright, let's go behind you. Let's see how much the down special does. If I can land it. There we go. I just stood straight in that. There we go. Give me that maximum tomato. Give me that smart bomb. Ooh, this is going to be nice. Oh, I hit myself on that. That was an accident. So these auto lances, you kind of take off their heads and it's kind of gruesome in a way, but to be fair, it's just an auto lance, nothing too special. And we got a ton of fire ashes. My aerial turned into using the ray gun. Oh, that was sick. That up special just made really quick work of all those fire ashes. And I picked up the ray gun again. I do not want it. Keep shielding and you'll get through it somehow. Alright, let's just tornado with this auto lance. Oh dear, I'm going to die real soon. Ouch. Alright, just do a couple up smashes, grab those maximum tomatoes. Be really careful, this auto lance. And let's just spam his neutral A. When I mean neutral A, I mean in terms of the GameCube controller. So, that was a mouthful, oh my goodness. Let's just relax and go through the door. And we're in a cave now. So, oh dear. We are getting introduced to the minecarts. And I love these things. Because you just ride them and you do whatever. So here is a not so secret door, which will lead us to a minecart containing a golden box and a normal blue box. And this contains Charmander. Charmander's cool. And now we have to run all the way back because there is no way for us. There's no transport, unfortunately. Alas, if we go back out here, and I think we're going to be forced into a battle right here. I kind of want to get this. Oh no. We want to get rid of that bucket as soon as possible. Don't have to deal with it. There's going to be another one spawning, of course. Just up smash this thing. Well, yeah, they did nerf Meta Knight in Smash 4, but I'm not actually sure in terms of Smash 4 tier listing where he's at, but I've heard that he's no longer broken. But then again, Sheik is still a thing, and Diddy Kong and whatnot. Here we get a heart container for our troubles, and we've entered back into the minecart. And as you can see, there should be a warning sign here, meaning that if we stayed in that minecart, we would have actually died, but thrown us back into the bottom. And I believe what this minecart tries to do here is bait you a little bit. So what you want to do is, when you see the caution sign, continue going for a little bit and then jump off. You should be able to, doesn't matter what you do with Meta Knight, but as you saw there, if you were with Marth, you might have not been able to make it if you just jumped off. Oh dear. I'm an idiot. Might have not been able to make it to this platform here. But anyway, I think we're done. Are we? No, we're not. We're back on the surface. Where did we go? I don't know. And here, we're going to be introduced to a new character in Super Smash Bros. Brawl, Ike. So, Ike is the Fire Emblem character to replace Roy from Melee. And a lot of people like Ike. Final... that's his chant. We like Ike. But, yeah, Ike fights for his friends, and he is, like, he's extremely strong. That was pretty cool. I did like a little backflip. But anyway, Ike, he's very strong, but he's also quite a slow character. His smashes are insanely powerful. And he's got a really fast back air, which is really good for punishing. And it's a pretty good kill move, too. His up special is Aether. And it's not entirely the best for recovering. In fact, his side special is a lot better because you can charge this up and you go quite a while away, so if you double jump and go in the air, you can actually recover quite well horizontally. And his neutral special, you can charge this thing up, and however, if you charge it too far, you will take some damage, in that case 10%. And his down special is the standard counter, like a lot of Fire Emblem characters. But, if we keep going, I kind of thought this was the end of the level, that's why I was just sitting put there. I'm sorry, that was my bad. Let's see. There we go. Let's pick up a bit of food, deal with some fireishes and primids. Oh, that back air. I love it. The neutral air is quite good as well. Just keep up smashing this thing. Okay, let's just pick up... Oh, no. Jeez, he's so powerful. I love it. Get a maximum tomato for our troubles. Also, I'm going to just make quick work of all these enemies using this hammer. Man, you get so much knockback on that, on the side tilt. But yeah, here we are with the rays of light, and that should signal the end of the level. Damn, looks like the Ancient Minister just keeps getting away. Anyway, trophy-wise, damn, we got 3 Sword Primers. Chain Chomp, Totodile, and Charmander. Sticker-wise, we got the Lon Lon Milk from The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, Propeller Shygo from Yoshi's Story, Orbalon from WarioWare MPG, and Deoxys from Pokemon. Ah, warrior, greed never gets you anywhere. Marth, Meta Knight, and Ike have joined our team. And with that, geez, that was a long episode. I don't know if I'm going to split that up into two parts. But anyway, that's going to be it for this episode, because we did quite a bit. We went through the Battlefield Fortress and the Ruined Zoo. So next time on Super Smash Bros. Subspace Emissary, we are going to head into the forest. So if you did like this video, please rate, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter for more updates. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!